Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Uncle Sideways, and I'm just here with some more Let's Play this year, Warcraft 3, Reign of Chaos, Orc campaign, on that there PC. And now it's time for us to start Chapter 4, The Spirits of Ashenvale. As soon as I hit that button and we hit that black screen before the loading screen, I was genuinely worried. I had immediately, somehow, like that shit when you look at your watch to check the time, but you don't actually fucking absorb the information. Like, oh, well, nowadays, look at your phone, I suppose. I don't even know why that, I fucking never wore a watch. Last time I had a watch on was when I had a pocket watch and I was in secondary school. Jesus fucking wept. Anyway, doesn't matter. 2 days later, along the borderlands of Ashenvale, do you mean the border? The borders. Not the borderlands. It seems like a bizarre, I mean, that's probably grammatically correct. It just seems like a bizarre way to phrase it. Like a slightly unnecessarily flowery way to say the edge. You know what I mean? Oh good, we've got the Night Elves.
Damn Thor for sending us away. He chooses to use his greatest warriors for manual labor. You'll be lost without me.
Chieftain, there's something strange about these woods. It's too quiet. Almost like we're being watched.
Also, there's like glowing things on some of the trees.
Are you afraid of spirits now? There is nothing here but ancient trees and shadow.
Anaduna farore, iseraduna bantos,
Ashtarod nefanas.
You hear that? This place is haunted. I fear no living enemy, but my axe cannot cleave fleshless spirits.
Still your tongue and get to work. The war chief's new settlement will require a great deal of lumber. This section of forest must be cleared.
Cool. Right, so now it looks like we've actually got Shaman. Do you guys actually heal people? I think they do? I'm not sure. I fucking hope they heal people. But more importantly, we've got good old Gromash. One of the Blade Master. Blade Masters who have always and likely will always be kinda weird to me. As like just as a thing in Warcraft lore, they've always been a bit odd to me. Like, I've always thought of them as being a bit peculiar. So what's our actual goal here? Amass a shit ton of lumber. Okay. So this is basically, if I recall correctly, this is basically a base defense.
I can wait no longer.
We need more gold.
Sorry, give me just a moment. Sorry about that little cut there, ladies and gentlemen, but there's a very good reason. Basically, as I'm sure you ladies and gentlemen know, possibly by now because it's fucking summer, so this has actually come up in multiple videos at this stage. Your boy is like deathly afraid of wasps and bees. Like it's just a serious, like hardcore
we're under attack.
Phobia of wasps and bees. And yeah, a massive bee was just in my room, so that had to get dealt with. Yeah, bit of an issue. And yeah, that's just, I can't even what the fuck I was saying. I was saying something, but fucked if I know anymore, hey? You know what I mean? Like, I couldn't.
They're women.
Couldn't tell you.
Yes. They almost look like elves. But they're far too tall and far too savage. I can wait no longer.
Hang on. Sorry. What the fuck is Grom attacking? Oh, the sprite. Oh, okay. Well, that's not even Grom, that's Mirror Image, but yeah, no, I just fucking shat myself inside out because of a bee. Like, a big fucking bee. And the worst thing is that I'm willing to venture possibly the same bee was in my room, like, yesterday. Like, I don't...
What do you want?
The same big fucking dumbass bee was in my room being thick as pig shit, like, yesterday as well. So... yeah, don't know, couldn't tell you. Where the fuck is...
Vengeance for Surji.
Oh, is there not a gold mine? Do we not have a... Are we...
Shit, we're not making any gold. Okay, fuck. Do we have pillage? No, we don't have pillage. Let's get pillage. Fuck. I did not realize that we didn't have a gold mine. That is actually... That's a bit of an issue. The fact our lack of a gold mine.
Finally.
Fuck. How are we gonna... Okay, I fucking saw something over it. Okay, there's a gold mine over there.
Women have returned on flying beasts.
They won't last long after our wolf riders have ensnared them.
Okay, so the big question here is, do our wolf riders actually fucking have ensnare? Because thank Christ, the game has actually just given me ensnare. I actually thank Christ for that, because if the game didn't give me ensnare, I would have actually just rendered myself unable to play any more of this fucking map. Okay, so we've got... Right, we've got a thing there. But I don't...
No problem.
Okay, so we're not exactly... Right.
Be happy to.
Fucking go gather gold. We need gold right now. Gold is like our main priority at the minute. Cause we're poor as shit. Meanwhile, I'm gonna send these guys off like exploring around, seeing what can be seen out and about. Cause there's two optional quests here that I do not know of. Right. That looks like a massive trap. Yep, thought so. Massive trap, we're being attacked by evil forest spirits of some description. Always good when, like, literally nature itself is a massive dick. It's actually one of the peculiar things about World of Warcraft that comes again. Your boy's gonna talk about World of Warcraft from a roleplayer's perspective. Again. Are you ready? Fuck. I mean, if you're watching this far into this fucking series, like, you're probably down with me talking a lot about World of Warcraft lore and roleplaying and such. But, yeah, there was this issue. This issue in World of Warcraft is, like, which a lot of people don't really talk about for one reason or another. And the issue is essentially the fact that nature is a dickhead in the setting of World of Warcraft, which isn't, like, necessarily a problem. It only becomes a problem because people seem to forget that nature's a dickhead. And at times even the writers seem to forget that in World of Warcraft, nature is a dickhead. Because there's really, in World of Warcraft, there's like two kind of magical forces that are...
We're under attack! Oh,
shit, we're under attack. Yeah, there is really two kinds of like magical nature forces, like personifications of nature. One of which is elementalism, which is what the orcs do. It's what the orcs practice. Although not at this stage and as much, but that's like shamanism, is the worship of elemental forces. And then there's druid magic, which is the worship and use of kind of the raw power of nature. So like trees and animals and shit, as opposed to anything else. It's like raw. Yeah, it's like pretty fucking straight up like raw magic shit. Raw, like, elemental bullshit. And the thing is, both of those are dickheads. Like, like both sides of it are massive assholes. Because one of the most, like, iconic villains from WoW as a setting is the Fire Lord Ragnaros, who is the elemental lord of fire. And, like, people just seem to forget that the elements are notably assholes. Like, it's not just me being weird. It's, like, actually just a thing that elementals are massive dickholes. Yeah, it's just a thing. That always bothers me when things just kind of quietly decide to not mention it. But you got that. And that's, yeah, so you've got in that aspect, the elemental forces in the world are massive dickholes. But then you've also got the fact that, like, maybe not necessarily druidic magic, but certainly, not necessarily all of it, but certainly aspects of druidic magic is really dickish. Like the massive restrictions on construction and like to a degree beyond what could be considered reasonable. You know what I mean?
Ah, greetings, good orc. Strange to see one of you in these parts.
We are here to cut lumber, little goblin.
Well, there's this tribe of bear men called Firbolgs in this region that's been giving us trouble. If you kill the chieftain, we'll sell our goods to you at cost. We might even let you borrow a few shredders.
I'll consider it.
Well, that would certainly solve our lumber problem, and I did recall that we get goblin shredders. Get goblin shredders. In this level, but I just couldn't quite remember how. But cool, let's go beat up those furballs we noticed earlier. But yeah, no, because druid magic is also dickish, because, yeah, like, the trees can just come alive and kick fuck out of you. And that generally druids have, like, an unfortunate history of not talking. Case in point, actually, this entire thing of the night elves just attacking us, this becomes, like, a big problem later on, and granted, half of it is, like, because Grom's, like, and it's fucking warmongering dickbag, but, like, they didn't say anything, they just kind of, like, and the fucking night elves at this stage, they don't know who the fuck we are. I'm not feeling bad about just outright saying that they're night elves. We all fucking know who it is. If we know anything about World of Warcraft, they're one of the core races. It's not as if I'm not fucking surprising anyone by going fuck BT dubs. These purple pointy-eared people are night elves. It's not to anyone by surprise. But the night elves, they didn't fucking say shit. They just attacked us. I'm like, yeah, sure, the magic's I get it. Like, this shit's important to them. You know what I mean? I get it. Nature, yes. Cool, sure. Important to you. But maybe, like, have a word. Like, maybe don't just, like, immediately go to attack. Maybe just don't immediately kill us. Is my thing. That's what I'm saying. Do you know what I mean? Don't instantly go to murder. There are better ways than immediately murdering us. Do you know what I mean? To, like, avoid the conflict. I mean, fuck. Just, like, tell us to go fucking cut trees down somewhere else. But this ended up being the basis. This is, like, genuinely, this one level is the basis for why the Night Elves joined the Alliance. Damn it. Genuinely. It also proves the Night Elves are, like, huge hypocritical dick fucks. Things do actually get worse from here, actually. The conflict escalates. So yeah, it's not just this. I'll give you that.
Now, these shredders will cut through those trees in no time. See.
Cool.
Something to do.
Now I'm gonna actually just take the peons off of tree cutting duty and put them on gold duty. And literally just have shredders doing all of the wood cutting. Can I get more shredders, actually?
How can I help?
Do you sell me shredders? Yes. Yes, you do. You will sell me shredders. And actually, shredders are, like, pretty decent in melee, so in a pinch, we can also use them to fight. Right, I'm gonna just put my military over here for now, because I'm gonna basically restructure everything so that all of my armies are, like, over there.
Those dancing lights are strange. Perhaps they are the dread spirits that you've all been so afraid of.
Grom, could you sound like a little bit less evil? Like, it would really help the cause if you were a bit less evil sounding. Fucking keep chopping down trees, shredders. Come on now. Like, I'm not gonna put much here. I'm just gonna put some defenses in this area, really.
Work complete. What you want?
Yeah. Hi there. How you doing? Whoops.
War chief.
Yeah. Lads, got airborne dick holes.
Four doom hammer.
At least we had airborne dick holes, and then we rather dramatically brought them back down to Earth. What's Blade Storm? The Blade of Destructive Forces around the Blade Master rendering immune to magic and dealing good.
Finally. Yes.
Right, let's just fucking let's build some towers. Let's get some towers going. Actually, what we're doing now, I suppose. Let's actually also just go and do some exploration. Okay, you guys. Yep, you finished the trees over there. Fuck these trees up.
War chief.
Always be fucking up trees. That's my instructions to the Goblin Shredders. Always be fucking up trees. Fucking really. We've been gone for like 10 seconds, and immediately the foe appeared. Hi guys. I turned up explicitly to like fuck you guys up worse. Now you know what? I'll give this game something. That is a potent high level spell. I will give the game that. That is a potent high level spell.
Something you're doing?
Okay, let's. No, I don't want to build a fucking. Let's. Where's the watch?
There we go. Work.
Smack down another watchtower. You as well, actually. Let's just fucking slam watchtowers down.
What do you want?
Can we afford another watchtower? Yes, we can.
Work. Something you're doing?
I mean, it requires that the enemy focus on the watchtowers and not on the actual grunts. Well, not the grunts, the peons, rather. So it's always good. This is investing in their future, is what this is. I'm looking after them by doing this. And also, because the towers can hit flying units. So, yeah. And actually, now the shredders are going to be doing work. I'm going to actually set you guys to 5, so I can just like.
Work complete.
Yeah, go chop that down. Oops, someone's work finished complete. To watch the tower.
What do you want?
Oh.
I can do that. Something you're doing?
Gonna start putting the other peons back to work now. There we go.
Work complete.
I think I'll put.
Yes.
Ideally, one more tower, like. But in, like, around here. Maybe actually there.
We're under attack!
Oh. What? Where? Where? Sorry, he just yelled we're under attack, but I really don't see where the attack's coming from. Yeah, that's just confused me. Don't scream we're under attack if we're not under attack, man. It's just rude. How's this one tower doing?
We need more work complete. Something
good. Yeah, one more tower there. That'll do us well. That'll do us very well. Oh, right! So every time I actually buy shit, the amount of lumber I've harvested goes down. I suppose that makes sense. I'm supposed to be building a stockpile. Spending it isn't exactly a good. Like, yeah, it's built. Like, spending the stockpile isn't exactly the best way to maintain the stockpile, I suppose.
We need more gold.
Yeah, I'm just kidding. Yeah, at this stage, it's not really. Really? Yeah, I was fucking confused there, because these guys did seem like they were happy to just walk around that patch of trees. As if somehow they decided that those trees had religious significance, but all the other trees in the forest could actually go fuck themselves.
Work complete for the horde. Yes.
Ah, good. We're going you as well. Though it does rather seem that we do have a bit of an upper limit in terms of how many orcs can possibly be. You know, I'll take one peon off of gold gathering duty and put him onto, Yeah, there we go, that does it. Put him onto wood. duty. Actually, no, I won't put him onto wood duty. He can fucking deliver that, but he'll be the construction peon. Yeah, he's the construction peon. If we need a construction peon, he is the construction peon.
Yes? Huh?
Okay, let's get, I think, ideally one more grunt. And then I think...
We need more gold!
Yeah, then it's just trolls, me reckons. Then it's just trolls. I'm also looking at the time here and realising that I think this is going to be another one of those, I think this might be another two-part mission. Well, fairly as expected, I should think, that the missions start taking longer and longer the further you get through the game. Although, I will say, I'm slightly concerned right now, because I have just realised that we, haven't been attacked in, like, a good, solid while, and I don't know why, and I don't like it. What the fucking... Right, when you've done those ones, fucking go dig a... Well, not dig, but you get the idea. Go fucking...
Where should one me go?
Where should one me go? Sorry. But... Like, there's only so many times I can apologise for my bizarre fascination on the way they say Washiwami. Something, sorry, there's actually just something faintly entertaining to me about just the sheer number of towers all, like, gathered around protecting, like, this, as if this is, like, a vital trade route. I mean, it is! Like, it is a vital route. It's just, like...
Washiwami go.
I don't know, it's a vital but not exactly impressive-looking route, I suppose, is the issue. Oh, fuck, hi. Wow, didn't even actually get to attack me, did you? Oh, fuck, okay. Right, lads, we've... lads, we found, like, the rest of their army. I was wondering why it seemed like there was just one friggin'... Well, it seemed like there was just one friggin' thing. Hang on a minute. No, I don't need a troll. I need one of you fellas. But yeah, I was wondering why there was just like, why there seemed to just be a catapult. Because in my experience, generally, you don't tend to get, like, a catapult on its own. I'm also worried that we're about to walk into... Yes, we are. That's definitely a base.
Something need do.
Ready to ride.
Be happy to. We're under attack.
What? Right, we're under attack again. Where are we under attack from? Is it just saying we're under attack for like the sake of it
what
at this
you
stage? Because it kind of feels like that. Okay, cool, full force, good, let's keep going. But yeah, I'm thinking that up here is a Night Elf base. Which, actually, wiping it out might not be that bad. Actually, I wouldn't be surprised if the quest not yet discovered is actually a quest to wipe out the other Night Elf base. But, at the very least, hey, we've kind of proven a point that, like, this shit is an effective defense right now. Do you know what I mean? We're doing well, we're doing well. I'm actually thinking about going back to the goblins and, picking up ourselves. This is the Night Elf base. I'm thinking about going back to the goblins and picking us up a, picking us up a couple more shredders. Get this shit moving a bit quicker. Is this... No. Okay, this... I take it back. This is not a Night Elf base. Yeah, that didn't go well for you, did it? Oh, shit. Probably should've, fucking get that. Actually, get both of them down. Because those things are, like, kind of useless the second they're on the ground. I suppose it makes sense, flying units and all, but...
I can walk no longer. Weak-minded coward.
How, like, strong are you? Do you do, like, the same amount of damage that Grom does, or... I genuinely can't tell. I would reckon that he doesn't act, that the clone doesn't actually do any damage. That would be my theory. Which otherwise he's a bit... Otherwise he's a bit tough.
I can
wait. You know what I mean? Otherwise, like, that thing's a bit... Bit too useful, I'd say, at that stage. Get back to work.
We're under attack.
Where's the fucking? There you are.
Who you want to kill?
Hang on. Ah,
let
fuck it.
Survive.
I'm sorry. Did I just immediately lose someone else? I think I just immediately lost someone else. I think so. Yep. Yeah, I did. Yep. Yeah. Okay. Lost the troll again. You know, for troll regeneration, for having troll regeneration, these trolls aren't particularly fucking good at dealing with combat. Like the whoopsie daisy. Okay, lads, back it up. We're fucking packing. Go the fuck home. We're not digging in that direction anymore. Right, we're also not going up there. Well, maybe later, but like we're not. Right now, we're not going up there for the simple reason that there's scary things.
What?
Up there, if I'm being blunt. There's threats. Let's stay. No, fucking get a fucking run over here. Get the fuck out of range of them. Cheers. You know what? Fuck it. We're going home. Let's go home. There's no. I'm not.
We're under attack.
Not doing it. Great, I told them to go back, and they responded to that by... I mean, I suppose they did actually go back, it's just that they then... Yeah, they did go back to where they were told. I do have to concede that point. They did go back where they were told, it's just that on the way to going back where they were told...
I can wait no
longer. Not on the way back, they just then immediately started another fight, is the issue. They're not too clever. Right, I'm keeping the army there. I'm gonna go fucking...
I'll consider it.
I'm gonna send Grom to go hire more shredders.
Finally.
Alright, don't mind me. I'm just hiring some more shredders.
Ready to ride! War Chief. Say the word.
Hopefully the extra shredders will help out. Actually, let's set... Yeah, let's set those two shredders off and working while the first two are getting repaired. Yeah, I'll be fine. I need to actually bring Grom back here. Oh! Just repair... okay, so repairing them costs lumber. That's unfortunate. Unfortunate, but it's not like a big problem, I suppose. Unfortunate, but like fine. It's acceptably unfortunate. Right. Methinks I should probably deal with these guys, since they're like right there, and these guys are gonna like run into them, and that's gonna be like a consistent issue until I wipe them out. Oh, you fucking stay there. I don't know what the fuck. I don't know why you think you have permission to go fuck off with the other shredders. But you don't, I'm afraid. Well, you will in a bit. You just don't have permission right now. Good lads. Look at them. They are good boys. These are good lads. Sorry, there is just. This is a period. I believe I mentioned it a few episodes ago where I do just really enjoy watching. I really enjoy watching this, like, nature being decimated video games. It's one of the reasons why I was, like, super down for Factorio, and why, despite the fact that I'm terrible at it, I keep trying to play it. Genuinely, it's because I just fucking love... I am, like, hypnotized by, like, this kind of gradual changing of the environment.
Chieftain, that great tree pulses with magic. We should keep our distance.
Bah, am I surrounded only by cowards? It's a tree, like any other. Cut it down!
Okay.
Our town is under attack! We're under attack!
Okay, Shredders.
You see? The great tree provided us with an abundance of lumber. If we find any more, then we'll hack them apart as well.
Like, seriously, these fucking Shredders are, like, great as a combination of... They're great as a combination defense force and fighting force. It's pretty great. What are we lacking here? We're lacking a shaman. Okay. We have a... Oh, do we not have a... Huh. I guess we don't actually have somewhere to train shaman. Let's fix that. Oh. We got enemies incoming, but... Yeah, don't really have to worry about it. Yeah, doesn't look like I have to worry about it.
I can do that.
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah, that was fine. That, like, didn't actually cause, like, any issues whatsoever.
I can wait no longer.
Send him home, but everything be great. Actually, there's a thing. Should I? Is it worth? I'm like getting close to like having enough. Is it worth investing in this shit? Yes, I think so. Because like all of that, like two Shredders bring that back in one run. So yeah, that's entirely fine.
War Chief.
Yeah, that is like literally entirely fine. Like nothing could be more completely okay than that. Yeah, get back to repairing, dingus. And yeah, let's get ourselves that shaman cooking, I think. There's part of me that just kind of wants to have an entire army made up of nothing but Shredders. Like, it's like, I'm really tempted to just, like, get a fuckload of Shredders rather than an actual, like, fucking military force. In fact, I'm gonna fucking...
Yes.
I'm gonna build some more burrows, actually, see if I can't.
Happy to door of earth and fire. Heed my call.
Lovely.
Research complete.
I do really like the way the shamans look. It's a shame that there was never really anything put in WoW, I think, that looks quite like how the shaman look in this game. I mean, like, you can get the mask.
Yes,
I'll give you that. You can get, like, not exactly that, but you can get, like, wolf head masks. In fact, my role-playing guild, like, fucking basically everyone and their grandmother wears one. Because that's just the aesthetic of the guild. If you've got an entire guild of orcs that are all, like, they're not, like,
nearly hit our quota.
Shaman, but they're, like, kind of shaman. If you know what I mean. They pray like shaman. Yeah, they're based around the shaman religion.
Work
then, like,
it
makes sense. Sweet. Okay, let's get one more burrow. And while working on burrows, I'm just gonna quietly.
I'll consider
a real quick send Grom over there. And actually, while he's over there, I'm gonna. Nah, I think this area is fine. But just to make sure, I'll send the boys through.
Understood.
If you just gather all of them in one place, I think, at the minute. How much more do I need for you? Actually, here's the thing. How are we doing on
work
gold?
Complete.
I think we can afford one more without this being an issue. I think that'll be fine.
What do you want?
Send him in there.
Something you're doing? Be happy to.
Plop you there so you'll literally repair everything. At least you should repair everything. Oh, good. Good. We did research that covered everything in spikes. That's pretty good. What the fuck does being covered in spikes... Does this increase the amount of armor you've got? Or does the fact that you're now bristly as fuck actually help? I have no idea. Like, I don't know. If I was making the game, I'd make that, like, do damage. But I didn't make the game, so... Ah, well, such is life. Send you guys up there. Because kind of the issue is that I'm worried because there's, like... Hang on a minute.
Right away. Longer. Research complete.
Okay.
War chief.
So now we have, and fucking the dogs barking, Jesus fucking wept. But now we have a shit, what I can describe best as a shit ton of shredders. Cool, right, we're just gonna quickly go have a fight, don't mind us. Everything's gonna be fine.
Whatever you say.
Ah, good. This has all gone entirely well. This actually means that what we can do is once that mine has collapsed, we can actually just send everyone through here.
We're under attack.
What? Oh no! There's like night elves. Whatever shall we do? Oh no, wait, I know what we'll do. We will use the fact that we are piloting giant robots. Not giant robots, but we'll use the fact that we're piloting robots in order to in order to ruin them, as opposed to, like, worrying at all, really. Because, you know, big scary robos, isn't it? There we go, problem fucking solved.
I can wait no longer.
What am I missing? I'm missing another... I'm missing a raider again, aren't I? Yeah. Yeah, that's it. That's fine. Get another one, guy. Don't really think I need to worry about it. Okay, cool. Gold mine has. Gold mine's finally exploded. Cool. Take a bit longer, but now just go the longer way around, I suppose. You'll be fine. Although, actually, do I have enough gold to... No, not a barracks. Do I have enough gold to build a... No, not quite, but... Give it some time, and I'll be able to sort that out.
I'll consider it.
More trees there. Actually, you know what? Fuck it. There's like a load of trees around it.
Our town is under attack.
Oh no! The town is under attack by nothing of much value. You know, I was gonna cut the episodes, but I've just realised that because of the. Right, so the problem you've got there, my friends, is that I can fucking see you, so... Where's Gron? There we go, there's now two of you. Oh, would you look at that, I can do it again. Okay. Okay, that doesn't mean... Okay, so I can't have a shit ton of clones. Okay, fair enough. Good to have that cleared up, I suppose. Really not that clever, the Night Elves. Like, really not that clever or that effective against us. Yeah, this is a bit of an issue, I'm realizing, because of exactly how far the everyone has to go in order to get the fucking gold and shit back to the main base. Slight issue. Yeah, I was gonna cut it, but we're nearly done, so we'll be reet. Fuck, I might not even actually have time to, why am I sending the fucking shredders all the way down there when there's wood here? What is actually wrong with me? And if I keep them cutting wood up here, I can actually just, like, sit... I can just squat on top of them and protect them. Yeah, there's plenty of trees. Loads of wood. Where the bastard are half of you? Ah, so you're making your way through the forest, I understand. You know, it's a fucking wonder that there's any forest... There was any forest when I got here. given how easily it seems I'm able to just rip the fucking forest down, you'd think that there'd be, like, less of it. Nah, and of course the what a loyal little peon that is. That guy has actually just been following the shredders around all day. Like, clearly he's just been following the shredders around all day. That's, like, got to be what he's been doing, like, the whole time. And yeah, I think... I think that's actually the mission done.
Chieftain, the harvesting is complete.
Good. Then we'll start constructing the settlement immediately.
They start. I'm pretty sure we've built a settlement while collecting the lumber, but what? Right, well, that, I'm afraid, is gonna have to be all for me for now. I've been humbled by your uncle sideways, and well. Bye. Is it done? Okay, cool. So I'm just gonna quickly tell you about some links in the description. Not gonna take up too much of your time because you've probably got other things to do and other videos to watch. So in the description there, you're gonna find a link to my Patreon if you want to support the channel. Support me. Feel free to, you know, click that link and help me out down there. You'll also find a link to my Discord server where I talk a lot of bullshit and occasionally play games with folk. So maybe go down there, follow, join that Discord. Let's have a chat, you guys. Let's have a bit of an old chin wag. And you'll also find my Twitter, where I occasionally post dumb things. I think that's about it. Yeah, so I'm gonna go away now. Bye.